Hello students, this is Shailaja Vipute. In the last video, we have completed the first use of dimensional analysis, that is to check the correctness of given equation. Today, let us learn second one, that is to obtain the relation between given quantities. Before learning this method, first we will try to understand the meaning of directly proportional and inversely proportional. Let us take one example. Say in a shop you have purchased 1 kg of rice and cost of that one is 50 rupees. So 1 kg of rice, price of that one is 50 rupees. Say you have increased the quantity to 2 kg. Then definitely we will pay more than 50. Means we are going to pay 100 rupees. So if you purchase only 1/2 kg, then you will pay 25 rupees. Means what? If one quantity is increasing, even other is also increasing. If one quantity decreases, then other quantity also decreases. It is called directly proportional. Here, quantity of rice and price of the rice you have compared. Okay, so if quantity is increasing, price is also increasing. If you are decreasing the quantity of rice, its price is also decreasing. It is called directly proportional. Okay, then now let us take example for inversely proportional. Say to decorate a room, work is assigned to 2 students. Those 2 students will take to decorate one room, say 5 hours. Okay, 2 students and they are taking 5 hours to decorate room. Now what we will do, instead of assigning it to only 2 students, let us increase the number of students to say 10. So those 10 students, definitely they will take less time to decorate because work is distributed. Correct. So number of students increases, but what about the number of hours? It decreases. So one quantity is increasing, but other quantity is decreasing. Okay, so it is called inversely proportional. If one quantity increases and other quantity decreases, it is called inversely proportional. Usually, directly proportional or inversely proportional, we use to take the symbol, that is, say you are comparing x and y. X is directly proportional to y. Okay, this is called proportionality symbol. Okay, then if you are writing inversely, then you will write x is inversely proportional to y, means 1 divided by y you will write. Okay, so this one is for directly proportional and this is for inversely proportional. Here if x is increasing, even y also increases. Or if x decreases, y also decreases. But in case of second one, if x increases, y decreases. Okay? So this is about directly proportional and inversely proportional. Here, when you are using either directly proportional or inversely proportional, say you want to remove this proportionality symbol by is equal to. Say you want to write x is equal to. Method is you have to use one constant. Usually that constant is represented by the letter k. So x is equal to ky we will write. Okay. Similarly for inversely proportional. Fine. Now let us start the method, that is to obtain the relation between given quantities. Let us take one example.
Here already I had written one example. That is, the time period of a simple pendulum depends on the length of the pendulum and the acceleration due to gravity at the place. Obtain the expression for T, that is time period, by the method of dimensions. How to obtain this relation? So time period, it is represented by the letter capital T, length L, and acceleration due to gravity is represented by the letter G. Okay, so when such problems are given, how to solve? Try to understand the method. First, you have to read the problem properly. Here, the time period of a simple pendulum depends. So, till this, so time, what we have to do? Time period T. Here, depends words is there. Depends means it may be directly proportional or it may be inversely proportional. We don't know. So, what we will do? Depends means we will take this symbol. Okay. Then, it depends on. It depends on what factor? Length. So, you write it as L. So, whether it is L square, whether it is L raised to 3, whether it is only L, we don't know. That only we want to find out. So, you take one unknown here. L raised to X. Any alphabet you can take. Here, I have used X. Okay. So, T depends on L. So, L raised to X. We don't know the power. So, you take it as X. And it depends on acceleration due to gravity. Acceleration due to gravity is represented by the letter G. So, power of that G here in this relation, we don't know. So, you take one more unknown here. Okay. So, T depends on, time period depends on, instead of depends, we have used this symbol, that is proportionality symbol. It depends on what factors now? Length. So, length and acceleration due to gravity. Since we don't know the powers of L and G, that only we want to find. So, we have taken it as L raised to X and G raised to Y. That only I have written here, means it is typed here. But I hope that X and Y, it is not clear there. So, once again I have written. Okay. Hope you have understood the first step. So, first step is very important. If you write this one, then next step will be easy for you. Okay. So, how to write? T depends on. So, T proportional to L raised to X, G raised to Y. If one more term is there, then take that also. But take one more unknown for its power. Okay. Now, what is next step? We have to remove the proportionality sign. So, if you remove the proportionality sign, what you will use? You have to write is equal to. So, what you will write? T is equal to K. One constant you have to write. L raised to X, G raised to Y. Okay. So, name this one as equation 1. Here it is written. T is equal to K, L raised to X, G raised to Y. Name it as equation 1. Now, what we have to do? This is LHS part now. Okay. And this side it is RHS part. Now, what we have to do? We have to write dimensions of LHS part and RHS part. So, how to write the dimensions now? You have to write dimensions of first LHS part. LHS part is time period T. So, what are the dimensions? Writing the dimensions on both sides, you will get dimensions of time period means only T raised to 1 you will get. M and L term are 0. Okay. So, M raised to 0, L raised to 0, T raised to 1. Now, write for RHS part. What is RHS part now? In RHS part, the first one is K. So, if you want to write for constant, I hope you are remembering. We cannot use constants in case of writing dimensional formula. So, this K is constant. You can't write any dimension. So, neglect this K. What is next term now? L. What is L here? Length. So, it is L raised to X. okay? So L raised to x. I hope it is clear now. Okay, next. Next term is g. So g is acceleration due to gravity. Acceleration due to gravity is nothing but it is acceleration. What are the dimensions of acceleration? M raised to 0, L raised to 1, T raised to minus 2. Okay, whole raised to y you have to write. Next is L raised to x, write as it is. Okay, then what we have to do? You have to multiply this y, raised to y is there, no? For all the powers of m, l and t. If you multiply, you will get m raised to 0, 0 into y is 0. L raised to 1, but raised to y is there. So you will get L raised to y. Okay, this is L raised to y. Then t raised to minus 2 into y, minus 2y. Okay, now next step is LHS part right as it is. M raised to 0, L raised to 0, T raised to 1 is equal to, in RHS side, first write M term, M raised to 0. Now see this L term now. There are two terms. One is L raised to X, another one is L raised to Y. So how will you write? L raised to X plus Y you will write. Correct? Then T raised to minus 2Y as it is. Now what we have to do? In LHS part and RHS part, M term, L term and T term are there. So, you have to compare the dimensions of LHS and RHS. So, when you compare, what you will get? First term is M raised to 0 in LHS. In RHS also, it is M raised to 0. So, neglect it. What about the second term? In LHS part, it is L raised to 0. But in RHS part, it is L raised to X plus Y. Hope you know this one. If bases are same, you can equate the powers. So you can write it as x plus y. Here x plus y is equal to 0. Okay, how it is? Here it is L raised to 0, here it is L raised to x plus y. Equate the powers. X plus y is equal to 0. Similarly, see the third one. It is t raised to 1, here it is t raised to minus 2y. Equate. So what you will get? Minus 2y is equal to 1 you will get. Clear? Okay, you are equating the powers of similar bases. So when you equate, you will get x plus y is equal to 0, minus 2y is equal to 1. Then next step is, here you will get this y is equal to minus term, you are shifting here, means you are shifting minus 2, means into 2 to this side, you will get minus y is equal to 1 by 2, but y is equal to minus 1 by 2 you will get. Okay, this is into 2, you will shift it here, it becomes divided by 2. This minus sign, minus y is equal to 1 by 2 you are getting, it is nothing but y is equal to minus 1 by 2. Okay, you substitute this here in x plus y is equal to 0, you will get x minus 1 by 2 is equal to 0, or shift it here, you will get x is equal to 1 by 2, y is equal to minus 1 by 2, x is equal to plus 1 by 2. Means you got the values of two powers, that is L raised to x and this is g raised to y. You got the values of x and y. Now what we have to do? We have to substitute it in equation 1. So when we substitute it in equation 1, we will get t is equal to k L raised to 1 by 2 g raised to minus 1 by 2. Okay? So actually, this is our final answer. This is the relation between time period of a simple pendulum and length and acceleration due to gravity, that is L and G. But you can write one more step. I hope you know this one. X raised to 1 by 2. How will you write? If it is x raised to 1 by 2. You can write it as root x, correct? Square root of x. So here it is L raised to 1 by 2. How will you write? Root L, correct? Then G raised to minus 1 by 2 it is. You can shift it to denominator so that it becomes plus. So when you write this one, you will get last step as T is equal to K square root of L divided by G. Okay. So this is final answer. That is the relation between time period of a simple pendulum, length and acceleration due to gravity. Okay. Let us go for second example. So very simple one. Kinetic energy E of a body depends on mass m of the body and velocity v. Obtain the relation between given quantities using dimensional analysis. So what is first step? You have to read the sentence. When it comes depends, you have to write proportionality symbol. So kinetic energy E, see the problem here, kinetic energy E of a body depends. So E proportional to, okay, mass m. So again you can take m raised to x, velocity v raised to 1. Now you have to find out the values of the powers x and y. How to find out? What is next step? You have to remove the proportionality sign. So if you remove the proportionality sign, you will get E is equal to K m raised to x v raised to 1. Let us name it as equation 1. Now we have to write the dimensions of LHS part and RHS part. What is LHS part? That is E, energy. What are the dimensions? M raised to 1, L raised to 2, T raised to minus 2 is equal to K, constant, neglected. Next is mass. So m raised to 1. Raised to x is there. So you write raised to x. What are the dimensions of velocity? M raised to 0, L raised to 1, T raised to minus 1. Whole raised to y is there. So you write y. Means you have written dimensions of energy, mass and velocity. Okay. Then next is, let us simplify by multiplying the powers by the x and y. So first one is m raised to 1 raised to x multiplied. You will get m raised to x. Now multiply these three powers by y. You will get 0 into y, 0. L raised to 1 into y, L raised to y. T raised to minus 1 into y, T raised to minus y. Now write it in one bracket. So you will get LHS part as m raised to 1, L raised to 2, T raised to minus 2. And RHS part is m raised to x, L raised to y, T raised to minus y. Now what we have to do? We have to compare the dimensions of LHS and RHS of the equation. We get, let us compare what we will get. Here it is m raised to 1, here it is m raised to x. Equate the powers now. X is equal to 1. Okay. Now see the next one. It is L raised to 2. Here it is L raised to y. Equate the powers now. Y is equal to 2. So you got values of x and y. No need to equate third term. Okay. By say, if you equate, what you will get? This is T raised to minus y. This is T raised to minus 2. So you will get minus y is equal to minus 2. Again it is y is equal to 2. Correct. So no need to write it twice. Only once you can write. So you got the values of x and y. Substitute it in equation 1. You will get e raised to k m raised to x. What is value of x? 1. Okay. So m raised to 1. V raised to y. What is value of y? 2. So you will get V square. Correct. So E is equal to K. Instead of writing M raised to 1, only M is written. It is understood. M V square. So this is a relation between given quantities. Here you don't know the value of this k constant. Actually, this is the drawback or disadvantage of dimensional formula. Okay, take one more example. Third one, centripetal force F depends on mass m, radius of the circular path and velocity. Obtain the relation.
So centripetal force depends, F depends, so F proportional to, okay, mass m, m raised to x, radius r, r raised to y, and velocity v, so v raised to z. Here F depends on three factors, so m raised to x, r raised to y, v raised to z.
Next step is remove the proportionality sign. You will get to F is equal to k, m raised to x, r raised to y, v raised to z. Now what we have to do? We have to write the dimensional formula. So write the dimensional formula for force. You will get m raised to 1, l raised to 1, t raised to minus 2. K is neglected in RHS part. Write the dimensions of mass. You will get m raised to 1. Raised to x is there. So write x. Radius. Radius is nothing but it is length. So you write l raised to 1 raised to y. Next one is velocity. So velocity is m raised to 0, l raised to 1, t raised to minus 1, raised to z. Okay. Next. LHS part write as it is. In RHS part multiply the power. You will get m raised to x, l raised to y. Then this m raised to 0, l raised to z and t raised to minus z. Again LHS part is same. In RHS part, this is m raised to x, l two terms are there, one is y, another one is z, add the powers, you will get l raised to y plus z, then t raised to minus z. Now equate the quantities. If you equate the dimensions, you will get here m raised to 1, it is m raised to x. Equate it, you will get x is equal to 1. So one value we got. Now equate second one, l raised to 1, here l raised to y plus z. So y plus z is equal to 1. You don't know the value of y as well as z, correct? Now go for third one, it is t raised to minus 2, this is t raised to minus z. If you equate it, you will get minus z is equal to minus 2. So minus minus get cancelled, you will get z is equal to 2, correct? So this z is equal to 2. You have to substitute here so that you can get the value of y. X 1 already you got, z value you got, but you want y now. So substitute it here. So what you will get? Y instead of z, you write its value 2 is equal to 1 plus 2, shift it this side, you will get y is equal to minus 1. So x value, y value and z value you got. Now substitute all these three in equation 1. So if you substitute in equation 1, you will get F is equal to K, M raised to 1, R raised to minus 1 and V raised to 2. This minus 1 shift it to denominator, it becomes plus 1. So you will get F is equal to K, M, V square divided by R. How it is divided by R? Minus 1 means r raised to minus 1, you are shifting it to denominator so that it becomes r raised to plus 1. Hope you have understood all these problems. Practice it once, twice, go through the problem so that you can understand the method and you can get the method properly. Thank you.